Cursul de design interior este susținut de școala Creative Learning, un curs cu 12 ședințe predate de Martin Clesens, ce semnează cele mai frumoase proiecte de design interior din România. Trăiește și lucrează în țara noastră de mai bine de 8 ani, iar în portofoliul ei putem găsi peste 30 de proiecte rezidențiale care par rupte din paginile revistelor internaționale de top. Cursul este adresat atât designerilor și arhitecților la început de carieră, care urmăresc aprofundarea unei metode de lucru în relația cu clienții lor, cât și pentru pasionații de design de interior. Este un workshop în care se lucrează foarte mult pe baza materialelor, texturilor și decupajelor, direct de pe moodboard, dar și digital. Un curs cu totul și cu totul prietenos, care te familiarizează cu metode, stiluri și etape de lucru, dar și cu resursele necesare pentru a profesa în domeniu. Regula de bază a acestui curs este de a învăța regulile conturării unui decor de la A la Z, trucuri și efecte ale tuturor coordonatelor, care, îmbinate ingenios, transformă un spațiu într-un cămin armonios. Pentru ca la final să poți avea un punct de plecare atunci când îți amenajezi casa visurilor tale.
Fashion in Antwerp. I worked for quite some years in Belgium before, in a way, following my dream and go to Italy, where I worked with friends in a studio, and I worked there for 6 years. And at a certain point, I was looking for a new job opportunity, and I got an offer to come to Romania to design a children's collection. So that was my first step to Romania, and yeah, I stayed. I do the fairs in Paris, Maison Objet, and I go to Italy to the fair in Milan in April, which is for me always the biggest inspiration, because you see the new things arriving on the market, but you also see schools, young designers, and they show really the new things which are which will be, let's say, on the market in a few years. They are developing new techniques. They're working with materials and bring it in a new way. They're like, for me, the source. Besides that, I'm watching movies, to see museums, reading books, also food magazines. I love to cook. So all these things inspire me, the colors, traveling. And you find a lot on the internet now also these days. So it's like a constant inspiration all day around, I would say. As a designer, I think it's very important to get to know the client, because it has to reflect their personality in their home. If you start by yourself decorating your home, then it's very important to know what you want to do in your home, that it also reflects your personality. And that is, I think, one of the most difficult things to do, because it's very difficult to really understand what you want. So when I start working with clients, I try to understand them. I give them boards to understand their style, the colors they like. Can also be for me interesting to know where they travel to or the movies they watched, because this gives me an idea of who they are. And as a designer, it's much easier to do that for somebody, because you have a distance and I can be very objective in what I see and understand it. When you have to do it for yourself, even when I have to do it for myself, it's much more difficult, because you like this, you like that, you like much more things than you can bring into your home. As a designer doing it for somebody else, you can make like a certain selection, and you know the things you will bring together will at the end be in a harmony. If I could choose, maybe I would go more like for a minimalist style, because I like when everything is organized and everything is clean. I like the minimalist style because you have very beautiful colors which are very neutral, and the materials. But if I know myself, I'm much more bohemian. I like a mix of styles, I like a lot of colors. I like to have things around me. I have books and magazines everywhere around. I also traveled with my furniture from Belgium to Italy and here, plus I collected things. I have different rugs on the floor, which are most of them are Romanians, which I really love. So it's quite colorful. It's quite a mix of modern and vintage in my place. That was a difficult one. I think it's... the first question is, what is bad taste and what is good taste? So what for me is good taste is maybe for somebody else like bad taste, and the other way around. I think you can guide people. I think taste comes out of you. I think you can educate to a certain level that you have certain lines or certain points which people should follow to have in a way a good taste or combine things. But then it's like you have to educate yourself to discover things, to discover styles, to read books, watch art little by little, to create your own style, and then somebody can guide you to through bad taste and good taste, and to say like, look, this would be a bit too much. This gets like kitsch. This gets, so somebody can guide you. Yeah. That is a story which started, let's say, 2 years ago when Alice and Adelina of Designist asked me to do a workshop. And then in the beginning was said, no, it's not me. I can't talk in front of people. It scared me a bit. And then I said, a few days later, I said, okay, let's give it a try. We'll do one, maybe two. And then I really liked it, and we turned it into an evening course. And I just started now the fifth group already. So I love it because every time I see new people arriving, and it's a course of only 10 weeks, so which is very short, very compact. I try to give them as much as possible information. And it's nice to see the progress they make in such a short time. It's really, yeah, exciting to see at the end. Sometimes I have students that I think like, this won't work out, and then at the end they come with quite some nice presentations, so I'm really happy. I think I like to inspire them, to help them on their way, like they have their ideas, and then to show them other ways of presentations, to look for styles they wouldn't think of in the first place. That's also what I do with my students. They have to go through so many styles that they discover, because in the beginning they come with the style they like. And then little by little, by forcing them to open their eyes and to see to other things, they can also learn from themselves. To be more, to have a bigger portfolio, to show people other styles than just their own personal style, and I think that's important. So I try to guide them through that process. I've seen quite some years now here, and I think it made like quite an also a big step. There is still a lot of things to do, and that is the most challenging and the most nice part of being here and doing interior design. There is also, it started more like a few years, even 5 years ago, when there was still the boom. It was much more show off. Now people get more into a Western European style, it gets more grounded in a way. There are a lot of beautiful places which are opening restaurants and cafes and things. What in the beginning was more superficial is now more, it has more depth. the interior design. I think it helps contacting a specialist before you start. It will save you money and it will save your time, because decorating a house, it's a full-time job, because there are a lot of things you have to think of when you think, I will decorate my house, I will look for some furniture. There are a lot of details, which kind of paint is going with the wallpaper, it has to be adapted, then I have to think of the curtains, I have to think of the electricity, where I'm going to put the bed, I need like plugs on both sides of the bed. So there are a lot of details you wouldn't think of in the beginning, but little by little you discover that maybe you need help. Doing it from the start will help you. It will also save you time, because maybe you start shopping, you see a nice armchair, you see a nice lamp, and then you see this and that, and at the end you put it all together and you see something's missing because it doesn't work together. So working with a designer helps you to have this harmony in your home through all everything, the colors, the materials, till the last details. For an artistic education, I think it's important maybe also to start early, to try different things, designing, drawing, photography, and to find your way, because everybody has his own way of expressing their feelings or expressing their beauty. I think it's important to have like, it's not that you can be a designer in an evening course. It's not, there are people, I know people going to London, they do a course of 6 months. It won't make you a designer. It is, as every specialist, they study 3, 4, 5 years. So it's also in design that you need like a good background. Because it's something, you have to be open and know trends are coming, how to follow them. It's not, if not, you're quickly stuck after one project and you're not able to develop it in another direction. So it is an education which will take a few years and which will continue on through life, because it's like something, there are always new developments, new colors which come. But that's also the interesting thing, that it's not something that stops after 4 years, that it's something which you can constantly, which will also make you richer as a person to discover all these things.